Hello! So, Mr. Ryuk, what have we got today?
Pow! Buxton Brewery, Wild Boar, Indian Pale Ale, 330 and 5.7.
Ooh, fantastic.
Quite a strong one.
Bang.
Well,
we've got the crown.
Plain silver.
Bang. So we're not going to spend much time on it.
Well, yeah, that's it.
There is not much to say. But
the label looks cool, though.
Yeah, I like the label.
The weird browny sort of mud colour, I guess I'd call it.
Yeah, with the two wild boar.
Yeah, the wild boars either side that are green, which look like they have arrows in them.
Yeah,
they actually look like they're lying down dead, possibly.
They are actually dead.
Yeah.
So
I've only just noticed that as well, looking so closely.
I thought that were actually two wild boar on the side, but they are actually
lying down
cold, by two arrows. And then you've got this seal with a castle, isn't it?
Yeah, castle of some sort, a steeple of some sort.
Yeah.
And then the background, which looks like it's a map.
That would be a map.
It's taken me a while to figure it out, but it's this and then the words here, I can't even make out what it says.
Is it Yorkshire?
Could be.
Anything else on the label interesting?
Buxton.
Ah. Brewed and bottled by Buxton.
Buxton
Brewery.
Fresh.
Buxton product of England.
It does have a little note. Wild boar pours a pale straw colour with a fluffy white head. It has aromas of spicy lime and mango with the distinct flavours of honey malt and fruit punch, followed by a dry bitter finish.
We're going to see.
Natural, unfiltered, unparcherised product.
Okay.
Well, yeah, let's crack it open and see this straw.
Okay,
yeah,
I mean, I wouldn't call
really
it
nice fluffy head.
This is, for me, is a very nice golden.
Yeah. No, I wouldn't call that straw. That's a little bit too dark for straw.
Yeah, yeah.
Even quite cloudy in yours.
Yeah.
A little bit of a bottle condition, more than likely.
Fluffy white head. I like the head, and
I really like the
look, man.
The colour does look quite sexy, I have to admit. It's got a really light bit of carbonation in there. You can see, even in mine, there is a slight bit of cloudiness. Let me just show you the end of the bottle cloudiness. But then that fluffy, nice head as well.
I mean, the looking is very good. I like it.
It dissipates quickly, but then it just makes it look thick.
I'm dying, man.
Oh yeah, get the that's really nice.
Yeah, again, very citrusy.
Yeah, very citrusy. I get the liminess, and
it's got the fruit. There is some tropical there. There is some mango.
Yeah, definitely. You can tell you're going to get a bit of a hoppy brew with the mouth from the smell. Oh, it does smell quite pleasing though, doesn't it?
Yeah,
it's quite nice.
It's a nice India Pale Ale.
Yeah,
the nose is very nice. Shall we?
Yeah, go for it. Cheers. Smooth.
Very nice, yeah. Mm. Very smooth.
A very, very distinct bit of aftertaste. Very sort of war creeping, but
I like the bitterness.
Yeah.
It's not too bitter, but
not too bitter, but it does grow.
Yeah, I don't know how to explain it. It's very, very big, but not too bitter at the same time. I like it.
Mm. Very malty, I would say.
Mm. But it's something that I wouldn't mind
a little bit as well, actually.
I wouldn't mind to drink it again. I like this. I'm definitely going to try again something from Buxton Brewery.
Yeah. No, it's really nice. Really nice on the smell. It is quite pleasing on the palate. It is a bit bitter for me, I have to admit. But
I don't know. For me, there is a lot of fruit. So it's very citrusy on the palate. And once the fruit is gone, you got the bitter kick.
Oh, yeah. And it does grow.
Yeah.
The bitter kick does grow.
Yeah. But I like it.
But it is nice.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Not a bad one at all.
And because I come from a place where there are a lot of wild boar. Thank you very much, guys. Buxton Brewery. Wild boar, very nice.
Yeah.
India Pale Ale, good.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Ciao for now. Take care.